Good evening, dear ladies. Let's bless Bezrat Hashem that we will all have this good to greet Mashiach Tzidkanu Berachamim Burim Bimara Bimeinu Amen. Eliyahu Navi, Eliyahu Tishvi, Eliyahu Viladim, Bimara Bimeinu Tzidkanu Elanu Bezakul Atov. And we will all have this good to see the building of Beit HaMikdash HaShishi Bimara Bimeinu Amen. Ki Ayin Vayin Eru Bishubad Mein Tzion. Ata Takum Terachem Tzion Ki Et Lechanena Ki Ba Moed. Hashivenu Adonai Lecha Venashuv HaChadesh Emenu Kekedem. And we all have this good to go to Eretz Yisrael on the wings of eagle and we all have part in Eretz Yisrael. בשם השם נעשה ונצליח, אין אומר בדו השם שפתי ותף הופיע גיטי לתך and everything that we're doing is בשם כל ישראל. לשיעור בעזרת השם is in the זכות of all of the נשמות we're giving ללו נשמת all of the souls that were murdered viciously by the terrorists on שמחת תורה on October 7 and all of the soldiers, השם יקום דמם, השם will revenge their blood. And Be'ezrat Hashem, this is also the Refuah Shlema for Klal Amo Yisrael and everybody that we mentioned. And it's also Lilu Nishmat, Mazal Tov, Bat Pinchas, Hanoledet Memichal, Aleha Shalom Tini Shuta Tzora Metzora Chaim. And Be'ezrat Hashem, Yeshuot, for Klal Yisrael and the whole world, May Hashem bring Shalom, peace upon us, Klal Yisrael and the whole world. בעזרת השם. So dear ladies, we are now before Rosh Chodesh Sivan. This coming Thursday night is already Rosh Chodesh. The first day of Sivan is Friday, this coming Friday. So בעזרת השם, we're going to speak about Shavuot today and also about Rosh Chodesh and בעזרת השם also this we are opening Chumash Bamidbar בשעה טובה. So let's go to Rosh Chodesh first. So Sivan, the month So the month of Sivan, the initials of the month of Sivan is this. The initials of the month of Sivan is Sof Yesurim V'Tchilat Nisim. It's the end of suffering and the beginning of miracles. בעזרת השם במהרה בימינו אמן. מהשם, בעזרת השם, make true, בסייעתא דשמיא, את הפסוק שהתגשם בנו, השם יילחם לכם ואתם תחרישו. That Hashem will fight for us. We're just doing the effort, but Hashem needs to fight for us. So זה סיוון, the end of suffering and the beginning of miracles. This is the initials of the month of סיוון. Dear ladies, and then on Friday when we do Musaf Shel Rosh Chodesh, remember Kedarkenu Bekodesh Besiyata Dishmaya, Arizal asks, why do the children of Israel pray, they are davening, and sometimes the prayers are not answered? Because they don't know how to concentrate on the right combination of the name of Hashem. King David says in Tehillim chapter 91, Ki bichashak ba'apalteo asagveo ki adashmi ikreini ve'enehu imo anochi betzara achalzeo ba'achabdeo. Which means, because he knew my name, I am going to give him salvation. What name? So the name of Hashem, Yud Kei Vav Kei, the name of mercy of Hashem, and also the name of Hashem of repentance, they have 12 combinations. That name, like it's written in the Siddur, the combination is for the month of Nisan. But the other combinations, every month, the letters change place inside the name of Hashem. Okay, so what is the combination now for the month of Sivan? It comes from Parashat Truman, chapter 26 in Chumash Shmot, and it's about the Mishkan, the holy tent, the tent of meeting. And this is the combination of the month of Sivan. This is beautiful. And I'll just explain to you in a minute why. Okay, so we have the letter Yud, I'm writing over here, the letter Yud, the letter Vav, and then double Hey, okay? Yedotav ulezela ha-mishkan ha-sheni. It's the building, the walls of the Mishkan. And then we have, I'm writing Kuf because I can't write Hey, but this is the one combination of the name of Hashem for the month of Sivan. So when we come to Musaf of Rosh Chodesh, in the middle, in Tfilat Shmona Esra, we have Baruch Ata Hashem, Mekadesh Yisrael Barashei Chodashim, Blessed are you Hashem, who sanctifies the children of Israel on the first days of the month. So when we say Baruch Ata Hashem, we pose. And then we just visualize. We are not allowed to take any word out of our mouth. We just visualize the combination of the name of Hashem for that month. By doing this, we open a channel for abundance of blessings in all areas, towards Klal Yisrael and towards the whole world. So this is one combination. The other combination is the name of Hashem of the Tshuva, which is Aleph, and then Yud, and then I'm writing Kuf Kuf, okay? This is the second combination. So you just need to visualize it, to see it more, and that, so write it in the Siddur. Add it to the Siddur, this is next, write Sivan next to it, and then add this combination. You just look at the letters, and you continue. By looking at the letters, because we have holy eyes, the eyes are the mirror of the soul, okay? And we know that Ayin, an Ayin in Hebrew, is like 10 times Ayin. Ayin is 70, Yud is 10, Nun is 50, it's together 130, which means 13 multiplied by 10, the Kedusha. We have 13 attributes of Hashem multiplied by 10. With our eyes, two eyes, we have 260, which means it's the name of Hashem, of mercy, multiplied by 10. Zedek Dusha. This is holy. So our eyes are holy. That's why we needed to cleanse our eyes from seeing things that are not appropriate to look at them. So dear ladies, this is very important. So when we look at it, we open gates and we don't see it. If we would have seen this, if this curtain would have went out and our spiritual eyes could have seen what is around us and what we are doing in heavenly worlds, then there's no freedom of choice anymore. Hashem wants us to choose to walk in His way, to follow His way and His commandments. But once we see everything, there's no freedom of choice. We will, of course, we'll do what Hashem wants. We will cover our head, we will be tzniut, we will be modest, we'll do exactly what Hashem. We'll close our mouth, we'll use our mouth only for holiness, for Torah, for tzedakah with our mouth, which means we'll give good words to other people, we'll be nice, we'll teach our heart to that it comes from our heart. It starts first, you know, from the external part and then it comes to the internal part. But we would have done this without any question, because this is the will of Hashem. When did we see the Shekhinah? When did the Divine Presence? When did we see this? Shavuot. When we accepted the Torah on Shavuot. As in the Gemara, there's a machloket, there's a disagreement. Either it was on the sixth day of Sivan or the seventh day of Sivan. So we celebrated on the sixth. We have six and seven because we are outside the land of Israel. So we celebrate it twice, so it's six and seven. We agree with both of them. So, dear ladies, what happened is when Moshe Rabbeinu had to wake up the children of Israel after the 3 days of boundaries that Hashem first told him, put a line around the mountain of Sinai. And the mountain of Sinai was taken from Har Moriah. It's like in the portion of Chala that we take, so Har Moriah, HaKadosh Baruch Hu, Hashem took a portion of the challah and put it over there because Yitzchak Avinu was on the altar on Har Moriah, on the mountain of Moriah, which we have the a mountain, it's nika Har Abayit, Banglit, the mountain Har Abayit,
Temple Mount.
So and Yitzchak Avinu was over there as a sacrifice, as an offering to Hashem. So Hashem took it and put it, and I told Moshe Rabbeinu to put a line, because once the Divine Presence is going to come, to descend on the mountain, it's very holy. Anybody that will try to touch or come near, you will die. And then at that morning, when they, after 3 days preparing themselves, they weren't allowed to come next to women, to their wives, and they had to go to the mikveh because they have to be holy. And they have to immerse themselves in the mikveh, to put themselves in the mikveh, in the water, in order that they will be holy mentally and physically. And once they were standing all together. Vayichan Sham Yisrael Kenegedav. They were camping. Vayichan Sham Yisrael. Vayichan. They were camping. But camping in Hebrew, Vayichan, lo be'achanu. It is in singular, not in plural. which means they were all one heart, one soul, one heart. Only when we are united, then Mashiach can come. But I'm asking from Hashem that Hashem has to do something and to reveal Mashiach with Rachamim Gmurim, with great mercy, Bezat Hashem, to have pity on us, Bezat Hashem. Because we are almost 2,000 years in exile. And it's a miracle. Every mitzvah that we do, every commandment that we follow, every good deed, everything that we do in the sake of heaven, it's a big thing. It's bigger than the generation that received the Torah in the desert. Ad kedei kach. So we see that when he woke them up, this is why we have Tikkun Shavuot, because he had to wake them up. We have a fixing of Shavuot, the men the whole night sit down and study Torah, the women read Tehillim, we'll speak about it, Bezat Hashem. So after they were all up, then they saw that fire started coming out of the mountain. And the whole universe was trembling because there were thunders, there were lightning, brakim, re'amim. Can you imagine? All of the children of Israel are standing. There was a shofar that is going to be blown also when Mashiach is here. Oh, the whole world heard the shofar. It's going to be again when Mashiach is here. There was a shofar and all of the heavens were open. Seven heavens were open in order that the children of Israel will see there's nothing except Hashem. Everything is God. God is everything and everything is God. Can you imagine what they saw? They saw everything. They saw the angels. They saw everything. Everything was open. We are this generation that saw everything. Because Arizal says that the generation of the end of days is the reincarnation of the children of Israel that went out of Egypt. With us came Erev Rav, the one that converted. We can see them today also. The ones that converted and didn't really want to become Jewish, but they converted because of the fear of Hashem. And we can see it today, Tlo Aleinu. And Hashem will help all of us to repent, Bezrat Hashem.
Amen.
So, and not only to repent, but to love each other. To understand that the whole world stands on the children of Israel that study Torah. This is the Kodesh Berichu Oraita v'Yisrael Chad. Which means Rabbi Shimon Bar Yochai says that Hashem, God, the children of Israel, and the Torah are one. All of this was, all of the creation of the world was in order that the children of Israel will accept the Torah and will say Na'aseh v'Nishma. And by this, by accepting the Torah, there's existence to the world. By keeping Shabbat, there's a reality and existence to the next week, to the next 6 days. Otherwise, there's no 6 days. I know it's hard to understand this, but this is what it is. By us keeping Shabbat, we are becoming partners of Hashem, of the creation of another 6 days. Until the next Shabbat. Can you imagine? This is what, we can't see it. Only, lo yireni adam b'chai. When we pass away, only then there's a permission for the soul to see the divine presence. Why? In order to see, if we follow the way of Hashem, so all of the righteous tzaddikim come, the souls of the righteous tzaddikim come to greet us, and Hashem and the divine presence escorts us to heaven. And if not, chas v'shalom, God forbid, if not, then we see the divine presence and immediately the destructive angels come in order to take the soul. Can you imagine? But then, only then, we can see what we did and we didn't do. So first of all, this is opening our eyes and visualizing the name of Hashem on Rosh Chodesh. It can be only on Musaf of Rosh Chodesh. Furthermore, I'm reminding you, Be'erev Rosh Chodesh, we need to say the tefillah shel Hashalah HaKadosh. Okay, the tefillah. I'm going to send you also the... I'm going to send it to you in Hebrew and in English, that everybody can say this. This is good to say every day. or if you don't say it every day, so Erev Shabbat, which means on Friday night after we light the candles to see, yes, this is a good tefillah to say every Friday night when we light the candles in order to have blessings for our children, Be'ezrat Hashem. So זה תפילה לחולת ובפרט, and especially לערב ראש חודש סיוון, for the eve of the month of סיוון, להתפלל על עצמו that a person will daven and pray for himself ועל צאצאיו and over his children that they all follow the way of Hashem. Okay, this is from the book of the Shila HaKadosh. I'm reminding you, we're going to send it Be'ezrat Hashem in the WhatsApp that everybody will have it. And you all can recite it Be'ezrat Hashem. Okay, so the Shabbat, this coming Shabbat, is before Shavuot. It's called Shabbat Derech Er... Yes.
Can the parents participate in this prayer? There is usually parents fast before
that. זה לא כולם, yeah. There are people who fast before Rosh Chodesh, okay? We spoke about it, Sereman. Usually it's the men and not everybody. It's Nikra Yom Kippur Katan. Every eve of Rosh Chodesh is like Yom Kippur Katan. Why? Because we learned that every end of a cycle, you can atone for the sins that you did before, okay? So let's see, that the end of the week is Friday Mincha, נכון? The Mincha of Friday. So this, you can atone for the whole week. The end of day is Mincha, so you can, every day at Mincha, when you do Bidui, you can atone for all, but you have to, it's not enough to say, Chatati, Abiti, Pashati, I've sinned, and I've wronged you, Hashem, it's not enough. You need really to accept upon yourself to do Tshuva. Hashem knows our heart. It's not only words. It's not only the words, זה לא בלילה של מילים. You have to mean it. You have to think about what you're saying. We all have to think it. And when we say that, we ask from Hashem that He will forgive us and Klal Yisrael Be'ezrat Hashem. But you have to mean this and accept upon yourself not to repeat this and to say to Hashem, I'm sorry that I caused you a sorrow. You know, Amaran Yosef, it says בספר של תומר דבורה, של רבי משה קרדובור, and this is also in the זכות of the רמח"ל, רבי משה קרדובור, שעתו עליו ולשלום זכותות הגן עלינו, והרב סעדיה גאון עליו ולשלום זכותות הגן עלינו. So it says, תומר דבורה, של רבי משה קרדובור, he says over there that המרן יוסף, it was in the time, he studied also with the מרן יוסף, that wrote שולחן ערוך. Okay, the Shulchan Aruch that we have is Maran Yosef Karo, Alav HaShalom, Zkotot HaGan Alem. So the angel that was speaking with Maran Yosef told him, if you would have known the bitterness of the divine presence of the Shekhinah, you wouldn't want to eat anything. Nothing will taste good. You'll feel so sad. And so stressed from the agony that Hashem has that He doesn't have Beit HaMikdash and that the Shekhinah, the Divine Presence, is not in the land of Israel. It's with us in exile. It is in the land of Israel, but it's also in exile with us. So he says, if you would have known the bitterness of the Shekhinah from the situation that we are in now almost 2,000 years, you wouldn't eat anything. Can you imagine? And we don't pay attention, but it's each and every one, you know, Arizal says, and we are before Shavuot. Kol ha-mekabel kabbalah zoche lirot Yeshua. He who accept upon himself a mitzvah, a good thing, a good deed that he accept on, he, Hashem gives him the merit because he is trying to come closer to Hashem. So Hashem gives him the merit, God gives him the merit to see salvation. It's not hard. You know, it's not hard to put the shirt, not to go with a shirt like this, but to put it over the marpek, elbow. Over the elbow. It's not hard, it's only the evil inclination that gives us the imaginary thing. But think, it's better that we will be hot in this world, over here, than chas v'shalom, God forbid, hot in hell. Okay? So if we have a question mark, we just need to remember this. Because if we came to this world, we are going to go out of this world. And then we'll stand in front of the court of heaven. So everything comes, and Hashem, when He created Eve, when He created Chava, in every organ that He created, He said, Hei tznua, be modest, be modest. It's implanted in us women. And you don't need to learn what it is to be modest. Each and every one of us knows exactly what does it mean to be modest.
Yeah.
We have it inside us. But you know, all of the chevre, everybody does not. So eventually we stand alone in front of the court of heaven. And we can't give the excuse, but you know, all my friends didn't do it. So it wasn't time. I was waiting for my friends. Don't wait for anyone. Do what you need to do. Do the will of Hashem. By this, Mashiach will be revealed. It says, "Bizchut nashim tzadkaniyot nigalu am Yisrael mimitzrayim bizchutan atidin ligael." In the merit of righteous women, we were redeemed from Egypt, and in our merit, we're going to be redeemed now. It's not written in the merit of the men, but in the merit of the women. So we have it. We can do it. We have the strength to do it. Don't pay attention to anyone. Just do the right thing. Go by the way of Hashem. Influence others with a smile. Do it with a loving heart so everybody feels the light, the energy around you. So when you do it, everybody feels and they also want to do it. So kol ha'maaseh chaveru lidbar mitzvah kilu asah ba'atzmo. He or she that make his friend do a mitzvah, do a follow a commandment, or do a good deed, then it's like he's doing it too. Because he was the one to influence that person to do it. It's a big mitzvah. It's a big thing. So, Bezrat Hashem, now I'm going to go to Ezra Sofer. You know, remember Ezra Sofer that came up from Babylon to build the second temple. So over here, he gave that a year with all of its curses will be over, and the new year will begin with it, all of its blessings. Okay, so this refers to also Shavuot, and you'll tell me, what are you talking about? This is Rosh Hashanah. It's before Rosh Hashanah. We say that before Elul. We say it in Elul before Rosh Hashanah, before the month of Tishrei. And why do we say that? Because we read Parashat Ki Tavoh in Chumash Dvarim, and it has 98 curses over there. And we read, and I told you, all of the curses are really blessings. We touched it last week in the Shiur. It's hidden blessings. It's so high, the blessings, that we cannot, as human beings, understand it. So it's concealed. So then we read Parashat Ki Tavoh, then we have Nitzavim. We read Parashat Nitzavim, and then we have Rosh Hashanah. This is usually what happens before Rosh Hashanah. So Ezra Sofer put the portion of the curses, Ki Tavoh, before Rosh Hashanah. So if we have anything, something that we did wrong, by reading it and taking it to our hearts and feeling that this is happening to us literally, then by this Hashem forgives us, because this is a mental thing, that which means it's a spiritual thing that we do. And then we have Parashat Nitzavim, Atem Nitzavim Ayom Kulchem, that we are all standing in front of Hashem. And after that is Tishrei, which is Rosh Hashanah. But the same thing we have with Shavuot. Because Shavuot, we just read last week, Parashat Bechukotai. There's also curses in Parashat Bechukotai. We spoke about it. This was last week. We finished Chumash Vayikra. The last portion of Chumash Vayikra is Bechukotai. And usually, Parashat Bamidbar is before Shavuot, in order to have a separation between the portion of curses and the portion which truly. Those curses are blessings. You remember that we learned that Arizal says, what is a klala? Okay? What is a curse? This is in Hebrew, klala. Okay? As look how beautiful it is. Arizal says, don't read it from the beginning to the end. Go from the end to the beginning. That's what Arizal says. What do you get? So I take the hay, and then I take the lamed, and I take another lamed, and kuf. Zehalel! A praise to Hashem. And Kuf is 100 in numerical value. So I praise the name of Hashem. 100 blessings a day. You see? So this is a part of it. This is concealed. You don't see it. You see Klala, you take it very seriously. But truly, Bezrat Hashem, every time when you feel that there's something that it looks like a curse, say Bezrat Hashem, HaKadosh Baruch Hu, flip it to a blessing. With a smile, thank you Hashem. And Besiyata Dishmaya, Hashem will make it Halel, Be'abrachot Be'yom, 100 blessings a day. So, isn't that beautiful? So you see, oh, Ezra Sofer did the same thing now. He saw that Parashat B'chukotai will be, when we're ending Chumash Veikra, it was last Shabbat, and now it will be Bamidbar, and then we'll have Shavuot, separating between this, and Bamidbar, Bamidbar Sinai, in the desert of Sinai. And why in the desert of Sinai? Because this was the smallest mountain, desert, which means that everybody needs to learn how to be humble, because only by humbling ourselves and surrendering to the will of Hashem, then we are truly free. Look at the children of Israel. But first I'll finish this. So why is it also considered Shavuot like a new year? Because Shavuot, it says Masachet Rosh Hashanah, Daf Tet Zayin, it's written over there, Beshavuot Nidonim Al Ha'ilan. We are judged on the holiday of Shavuot about the trees. Which tree will have, the trees are also judged. If they will have fruits, what kind of fruits? It will be sweet that we will want to eat it, or it will fall and nobody use it. This is the time, this is the Rosh, like a Rosh Hashanah. So that's why it says, Rabbeinu Yaakov ben Asher, Baal HaTurim, says a beautiful thing about this. Pikdu ve'pischu, manu ve'itzu. This is pikdu ve'itzu, because we have before, Pesach, we have Parashat, usually we read Parashat Tzav. Hashem tells Moshe Rabbeinu to command Aaron and his children. Aaron the Kohen, the priest, and his children. So this is before Pesach. Ve'manu, to count. The whole Parashat Bamidbar, the portion of Bamidbar, is about counting the children of Israel. Okay? To count. And then Itzu. Itzu ze Atzeret, the Shavuot. So look, and what, look, Hashem counts us like diamonds. This is how He loves us. Each and every one of us, like diamonds, Baruch Hashem. So we see over here, this Shabbat, before Shavuot, is called Shabbat Derech Eretz. Like before Pesach, the Shabbat is Shabbat HaGadol, the big Shabbat, okay? Because of all the miracles that Hashem made for the children of Israel before they went out of Egypt. On that Shabbat, when they had to tie to the legs of the bed, the sheep or the goat to tie it, so in order to then sacrifice, it's a Pesach sacrifice. But now this Shabbat Derech Eretz, and why Derech Eretz? Because our forefathers that we learn Masechet Avot from Pesach, after Pesach until Shavuot, we learn Masechet Avot. This Shabbat is the sixth chapter. We are finishing Masechet Avot. Maaseh Avot Siman Nebanim, the actions of our forefathers is our, it's a sign for us, nahon? It's a sign for us, Baruch Hashem. So, this is before we receive the Torah, Hashem wants us to know that we need to refine, okay, our soul in order that we will appreciate life, that we will have empathy for each other, that we will love each other. This is the purpose. Because Hashem knows that we have good inclination and evil inclination. It's not an easy fight between both of them. But we, as Hashem tells us, follow the way of your forefathers. Avraham, Yitzchak, Yaakov, Sarah, Rivkah, Rachel, v'la'emotenu. So he says, follow the way of your forefathers. This is Shabbat Derech Eretz. This is the Shabbat before Shavuot is called Shabbat Derech Eretz. And now, Bezrat Hashem, we are going to Shavuot. So the Shavuot has a few names. First name is Shavuot with the Kamatz, the Shin, Shavuot. The Shin has a Kamatz, okay? But there's also Shavuot. Some say it's Shavuot, okay? One, some say it's with a Shva, And some say it's with a kamatz. Both of them are right, okay? When it's with a kamatz, it means weeks. Shavuot, we have 7 weeks until from Pesach to Atzeret, to Shavuot. So this is the kamatz with the oaths, the promise that Hashem gave the children of Israel and that we gave Hashem. Moshe Rabbeinu asked us, and we all said, after Hashem took the Torah and went to Esav, and he asked Esav, okay, are you willing to accept the Torah? What is written in the Torah? It says, you are not allowed to murder. We can't. Our father Esav murders people because Al Harbecha Techieh. Yitzchak gave him the blessing. You're going to live on your sword. So we cannot follow this. He went to Ishmael, and Ishmael asked what is written in the Torah. He said, you're not allowed to steal. We can't, because Ishmael, Yad Kol Bo, which means his hand is everywhere. So we see that they didn't want to accept. Moab, he went to the Moabim. Moabim said, what's written? You're not allowed to have intimate relationships that are forbidden. Not enough. We can't do this. So they didn't accept the Torah. Who accepted the Torah? Who accepted the Torah? The children of Israel. What did we say to Moshe Rabbeinu? Na'aseh v'nishma. We are going to do Na'aseh v'nishma. We are going to do, and then we are going to listen and understand and learn. But we will first we'll do all of the mitzvot. That's what we said. So Hashem said, you should be modest. We should be modest. That's what we said. We all gave an oath to Hashem. Na'aseh v'nishma. What did Hashem tell us? Vayitem li segula mikol ha'amim. You are going to be for me a special nation, my firstborn. Forever. And Hashem is forever. His oath is forever. This is something that nobody can separate between Hashem, the Torah, and Am Yisrael. We went from Pesach, that Hashem took us out of Egypt from Pesach, this is miracles above nature that Hashem did to us, even though we were in 49 gates of impurity. Then we started working on our character traits during all of the 7 weeks. We counted the Omer. And every week is parallel to a measure. Okay, a count from the Kabbalah, which is parallel to our character traits. Chesed, Gvura, Tiferet, which is mercy, might, and beauty, and then eternity, Netzach, Hod, Ve'esod, eternity, glory, and foundation, and then Malchut. That's the last week. Malchut is the last week. And then we come to Shavuot. We become a vessel of Hashem to receive His Torah. We become a vessel, each and every one of us. We are not the same human beings. Every Shavuot, the light of Hashem that gave us the Torah is again here, every year. And if we prepare ourselves, we don't see. We see ourselves like we look the same. But we're not the same. Spiritually, we're not the same. We are the soul inside the body. Each and every human being is the soul inside the body. The body is only a clothing. The body goes back to earth. But the soul goes back to Hashem, to the one that gave us the soul. So we are the soul. We prepare to become a vessel of Hashem's Torah. And if we took out all of the stones, you know, all of the things that bother us, and we do this, we just, you know, you sit around the table of Shabbat. And when you sit around the table of Shabbat, you know, or Shavuot, what do you need to do? To teach our children to say thank you. How do we teach them to appreciate everything that we have in life? By us saying, Hashem, thank you for our children. Thank you for the roof of our heads. Thank you for the beautiful table and the food and the drinks that are on the table. Thank you for my hands. Thank you for my legs. Thank you for all of my inside organs, inner organs, okay? Why? Please help me. Please help me that all of my body, all of my organs will always follow your way and do a mitzvah and do an act of kindness. And this is what we need to tell Hashem. Thank you, Hashem. Thank you for the root canal that I had. Thank you for the tooth that you took out. Thank you, Hashem. Yeah, mamash, everything. Thank you, Hashem. Thank you if your leg hurts. Thank you, Hashem. It's all from you, and anything that comes from you is the best thing for me. I just don't understand this, but it's the best thing for me. It's in order to cleanse me. Why? Because we are diamonds of Hashem, like a diamond. You take the diamond, you have to cleanse it until you see the light, and then it's worth so much money, the diamond. This is the same thing. This is our soul. The soul of the Jewish people is under the throne of Hashem. This is a diamond. It's a big schut. We see, we read Megillat Rut. Megillat Rut we read on Shavuot. And we see Ruth is a convert. She is a princess, the daughter of Eglon, a relative of Balak. You remember Balak, Bilam? She's a princess. There are two sisters. They are marrying the sons of Elimelech and Naomi, that they come from the tribe of Judea. And both of them, two princesses, they are marrying the children, Mahalon and Kilion. And they, both of them pass away, Elimelech and his sons, and they stay widows. And Naomi tells them, go back, your princesses, go back. I don't have anything, I'm poor. Go back to your nation. This is, she's trying them to see if they truly want to become Jewish. Opa in Hebrew is Oef. So she puts her back to Naomi, she goes back. From her comes Goliath. איך אומרים את זה באנגלית? גוליאת. From her comes Goliath. He's a cousin of the King David. And he comes, remember King David kills him. So, Ken, so wait, girls. And she tells her, this is a true convert. A convert that is not converting because he wants to get married to a Jewish person, a convert that is not converting because he is afraid of God, a convert that wants to be close to God, to be near God. We have this chut. It's a big chut, it's a big merit to be close to God, to be close to Hashem, to the Creator. Yes, Avraham. I'm not going about, I'm speaking about the root now. But Ken Avraham ben Avraham is also a convert. And he was very righteous. Rabbi Meir Baal HaNes is a descendant of converts. Rabbi Akiva ben Yosef is also a descendant of converts. Yeah, there are so many. Avtalion is also a descendant of converts.
And this is birth of...
Wait. We'll speak about it in a minute. Wait. So, B'siyata Dishmaya, we see that she tells her... She tells Naomi she doesn't want to leave. Even though she's a princess, she's going to go and she will be treated as a princess. Why would she want to be poor? There are converts that listen to the shiurim, the people that are converting. And I tell them, why do you want to join us? You see how the nations do not like us? And this is, in nice words I'm saying this. Why would you accept upon yourself 620 commandments instead of the 7 commandments? Because we have paradise and hell, and also the nations have paradise and hell, but it's parallel to the commandments that you need to follow, which means our punishment is bigger than the ones that only have to follow 7 commandments. You understand this? And this is a true convert. And you know, one of them told me, you are my people, you're my family.
So,
the Jewish people, this is a true convert that wants to convert because she feels that this is the right, this is the sparks of holiness that Hashem wakens up, because this is the end of days. Hashem is sifting all humanity. So Naomi tells her mother-in-law, she tells her like this, she says, כי אל אשר תלכי אלך, wherever you're going to go, I'm going to go. ובאשר תליני אלין, wherever you're going to sleep, I'm going to sleep. You'll sleep on hay, I will sleep on hay. Even though she can go back to be a princess. And then she tells her, amechami, your people are my people, like one of the converts told me. The Jewish people is my family. Unbelievable. מי כאן חי ישראל? ואלוקיך אלוקיי, and your God is my God. So we read Megillat Rut on Shavuot. Furthermore, Megillat Rut speaks about the birth of Obed, which was the father of Ishai and the father of King David. King David was born and he passed away on the 6th of the month of Sivan. So you can imagine. And furthermore, Baal Shem Tov, it's his yortzeit. These are two tzaddikim, very big tzaddikim. So we light a candle before. I'm reminding you to put a candle so we can light from candle to candle on the Chag. So we light the candle before, and we light for them candles, okay? So before the Chag starts, we light the candles for them, for David HaMelech, King David, and Baal Shem Tov. Rabbi Israel Baal Shem Tov, Aleim HaShalom, Zchutam Tagen Aleinu. So let's continue. This is Chag HaShavuot. It's also called Chag HaBikurim, the first fruits. The first fruits, the children of Israel at this time, because on Shavuot we are judged over that tree, Ki Adam Etz HaSadeh, because the man is the tree of the field. So this, when it says that we are judged over the fruits, which it means that over the souls, if we study Torah, if we follow the way of Hashem, it's mamash like before Rosh Hashanah. Mamash kmo lifnei Rosh Hashanah. Shavuot. Especially the men are judged if they study Torah in the morning at night, if they have a business and they're occupied, but they have obligation to study morning and night and to see that their children go to study in yeshiva, to study Torah. So this is a big thing. So we see Bikurim, the farmer puts a string around the first fruit that ripens. And he says, this is for Hashem, and only from the fruits that the land of Israel is blessed to. Which means that we have the seven fruits that the land of Israel is blessed with from Chumash Varim, Parashat, the portion of Ekev, chapter 8, verse 8, Eretz Chita Sora, Gefen, Tehena, Rimon, Eretz Zit Shemen Udvash, which means it's wheat, barley, we have olives, we have, I'm giving you by the order, we have olives, we have dates, we have grapes, we have figs and pomegranate. So all of this, they bring, if a person is far away from Jerusalem, from Yerushalayim, so he brings dried fruits. But if a person is close to Yerushalayim, he brings fresh fruits. And this is a big celebration, because they take the ox, they put everything on the ox. His horn is with a silver and gold they put around his horn. On his head they put olives. It's beautiful. Mm-hmm. And it's it's pilgrim to go to Yerushalayim. And when they come to Yerushalayim, the whole way they have a flu. And they read chapter 122 in Tehillim. They all read and sing it. And when they come, everybody in Yerushalayim, in Jerusalem, stops working in order to greet them, and they come in. And then they come to the Kohen and bring their basket. The rich people bring a basket of fruits that is all of silver and gold. And the poor people bring a basket of reed, Netzal Netzarim, of reed. And the Kohanim don't give back the basket to the poor people. They give them back the basket, empty, but the basket of the rich people, but not the poor. Why? Because they say by this, next year he will come a rich person, Ezrat Hashem, that he can bring the basket that is made out of, covered with gold and silver. And they say, Mikra Bikurim, this is the first 11 chapters, 11 verses in Parashat Kitavo, the parasha of the curses, in Chumash Dvarim. The first 11, you remember, and usually before Rosh Hashanah, we read this in order that Hashem will atone for us, for all of our sins, all of this Mikra Bikurim, that the person, even the king, he can't send a messenger, he has to come and bring it. And all of this, as the Arizal, Bikurim, Salenu al Ktefenu, we take the baskets. Just imagine all of the shayara that goes to Jerusalem with the baskets and the songs and the oxes that are walking, and they're all happy, and all of the residents of Jerusalem stop working and accept them and bring them to Beit HaMikdash. Can you imagine how beautiful it is? So yeah, it's overwhelming. Arizal says all of this that they bring from the fruits of the land of Israel is in order to atone for the sin of the spies that didn't want to go into the land of Israel. I won't go into it because we learned about it, but it's a part of the sins. It's to atone for the sins of the spies. Then Atzeret, another name, Atzeret. Look, Pikdu v'Pischu, Manu v'Itzu, Atzeret. The name of Shabbat is also Atzeret, stop. Like Shmini Atzeret, we have Sukkot. It's parallel to this. The eighth day of Sukkot is Shmini Atzeret. Hashem says, stop. I want you to be with me. You sat in the sukkah, you enjoyed with your family. I was there, the ushpizin, Avraham, Yitzchak, Yaakov, all of the seven ushpizin was there, the guests were there. I also want you to stay another day with me. Be united, that's what Hashem wants. Be happy, that's what Hashem wants. So he says another day, this is the same thing. From Pesach to Shavuot, Shavuot is Atzeret. There's parallel to the 7 days of Sukkot, there are 7 weeks. Mamash parallel to this. Can you imagine? We received Pesach, the celebration of the high holiday of Pesach in the merit of Avraham Avinu. We received Shavuot in the merit of Yitzchak Avinu. That was an offering on the altar. And we received Sukkot by the merit of Yaakov Avinu. So we see it's called also Atzeret, and of course Matan Torah, that we receive the Torah. We receive the Torah then. So look, Tikkun El Shavuot, for men they stay, the fixing of the night of Shavuot, they stay awake the whole night and they study Torah. We read the healing. Noah will put in the WhatsApp, we can divide it, we can read it together, because you need also the next morning to take care of the children, women that take care of the children, you need your strength. And then you have, it's a big thing to go with the children to hear the Ten Commandments. We prepare, because when Hashem descended, when the Divine Presence descended upon the mountain of Sinai, there was smells, reach. There was so good smells of flowers and fruits, and there was flowers everywhere. So we also decorate decorate our homes with flowers, just to symbolize Shavuot, like it happened there, the Siyata Dishmaya now. Furthermore, this is a certain, we spoke about Megillat Ruth, and Ruth, dear ladies, I'm wiping here. Okay, Ruth. This is the word Ruth, okay? Reish is 200, Vav is 6, Tav is 400. How much is it together? 606. With the 7 commandments of Bnei Noach, how much is it? 613. It's Tariyak Mitzvot Doraita, the 613 commandments by the Torah. You see how beautiful it is? And if you take root and you just add a hay, okay? Add a hay to this, then you have Torah. You see? The letters of root. It's a Torah. Letters of root with a hay. How beautiful it is. And we have a custom, dear ladies, to eat dairy food also on Shabbat. Know that in order to have Oneg Yom Tov, Oneg Shabbat, it has to be with fish, meat, and wine, okay? Mm-hmm. So when do we eat the dairy? So usually the men eat it after they finish studying, then they do mezonot and they eat the dairy food, and then after that, they have like 2-3 hours after that, they do a kiddush with meat and chicken and fish. They do a kiddush. So it says, why do we have machalei chalav? Because in Parashat Pinchas, chapter 28 in Chumash Bamidbar, it says, "Bakrivchem mincha chadasha la'Hashem b'Shavuotechem," that you sacrifice, you put a sacrifice, a new sacrifice on Shavuot, and the initials is b'Shavuotechem chalav. You see, chet lamed bet ze chalav. It's milk. You see, chet lamed bet. In Hebrew, it's milk. Okay. And what is the mem mincha? Mem is 40. So let's look. Lamed is 30. Chet is 8. Bet is 2. It's 40. So twice, like the 40 amount of, like the 40 amount of water that we have in the mikveh. Furthermore, dear ladies, Moshe Rabbeinu went to Mount Sinai for 40 days and 40 nights. This is chalav, numerical value of 40. And we say in Shir HaShirim, Solomon writes, chalav, dvash v'chalav tachat l'shonech, that you have the taste of the Torah is honey and milk on your under your tongue. So it's good to put also honey on the table, Bezrat Hashem, very important. And I would like to give you a few more things. I know it's a little bit, you want me to do it? No, today I'm going to do it. I'll give it to you now. Yeah, I'll try to do it as... Okay, so Sgulot for Shavuot, I want to give you, Bezrat Hashem. I wanted to give another thing, but we'll see. נהגו ישראל קדושים להיות נאורים בליל חג השבועות ולעסוק בתורה, which means until dawn they study the Torah, the men. We read Tehillim. Tehillim has five books parallel to the five books of the Torah. Okay? And it's the birth and the yahrzeit of King David, so everything that you say is heard. וכתוב בספר הזוהר הקדוש, and especially another thing, at midnight, which is approximately 12:54, something like this, that's the time on Shavuot to ask everything from Hashem. First ask Mashiach with great, mamash, great mercy that Hashem bring him, that Hashem will fight for us, that Hashem will save us and the whole world from all of this evil that is in this world. So you first ask for Mashiach, ask for Aliyah Nevi Zechul HaTov, and then Be'ezrat Hashem, ask for the soldiers that Hashem, that they will go, Ilchu L'Shalom Ve'Yachzeru L'Shalom, in peace, Be'ezrat Hashem. Help them, that Hashem will take, bring back all of the captured, Be'ezrat Hashem. This you have to ask from Hashem. Then ask that we will all do repent, we'll do the will of Hashem, and everything that you want, to get married, to have children, to have righteous children, everything that you want, good parnasa, everything, because it's like Rosh Hashanah. Okay, so everything. And let's continue. And it says, וכתוב בספר הזוהר הקדוש, רבי שמעון בר יוחאי says, כל מי שיהיה נאור בליל חג השבועות, ואינו ישן בלילה זה כלל, ועוסק בתורה הקדושה, יהיה שמור בעליונים ובתחתונים, ויוציא שנתו בשלום. Which means, he who studies the whole night, nothing, he won't die this year. He will be protected in heaven and on earth. כלומר, שלא ימות באותה שנה. And Arizal says, שהוראת חיי האדם בשנה היא תלויה בעניין זה. כי אם לא ישן כלל, ודאי שלא ימות בשנה היא. But remember, this is the job of the men. I'm not telling you to stay awake all night because we are women. Our job is to bring... Oneg lachag, to bring a pleasure to the holiday and to take care of the children so they can study. Remember, you get half of his studies. So if he studied the whole night, your husband, and he took the children with him, then you get half of it. Nothing will happen to you too, because you're a partner. This is one soul. So let's continue, Be'ezrat Hashem. And it says, וכתבו רבותינו בשם הירושלמי, הגמרא בירושלמי, שרבי חייה, נטל פתקה וכתב עליה, ביום השמיני עצרת תהיה לכם, אל תקרא, תהיה, אלא תחיה. Which means on the eighth day there will be עצרת, this is the name of Shavuot, and don't read it, will be, but will live. The hay becomes chet. תהיה לכם ארכות ימים, you'll have a long life and a good life בעזרת השם. המגלה עמוקות, he says this, בתיקון ליל שבועות, just understand, by reading Tehillim together, because I told you when we are partners in reading a book of Tehillim, it's like each and every one of us read the whole book of Tehillim. So he says that on Leil Shavuot, when we stay and study Torah, the men, and we read Tehillim, so even punishment, because of our sins that we created destructive angel, and it's supposed to be karet, elimination of the soul or the body, because we are reading Tehillim and we accept upon ourselves to be a vessel of Hashem, it becomes keter, a crown. Can you imagine? So please pay attention. Bezrat Hashem, when we spread out the Tehillim together. Furthermore, it says, okay, I told you, this is more for men. I'm going to give you for women, Bezrat Hashem. Okay, so everything, you know that the children of Israel, when they stood around the mountain of Sinai, they were all healed. Shavuot, we can all be healed, mentally and physically. We ask from Hashem healing and bless everyone, including yourself. Parnasa, v'Shavuot, we receive the Torah. This is a big time to ask for good income, Be'ezrat Hashem, so we can be available without engaging all the time to find how can we pay the rent, when we pay the yeshiva. So ask from Hashem, Imen kemach en Torah, Imen Torah en kemach. If there's no flour, there's no Torah, and if there's no Torah, there's no flour. So we need to ask for parnasa. Furthermore, zivugim. This is beautiful. Rabbi Nachman Breslov says, okay, we all know that when we have a kala and chatan, okay, when we have a bride and a groom, okay, so before they get married, Hashem forgives them for their sins. Why? It's not that he eliminates all of their sins. He puts it on the side. Mali, he puts it on the side. He says, if you're building now a home that is based on Torah mitzvot and you're not repeating the sins that you did before, then all of this is, you have a clean page. So this now, Shavuot, is a wedding between a Kadosh Baruch Hu, God, and us, the children of Israel. So if we accept upon ourselves the Torah, and we accept upon ourselves to do the good deeds that Hashem wants us to do and to follow His way, Bezrat Hashem, also for us, everything is put aside. If we don't repeat the sins that we did before, then everything is forgiven. Can you imagine? How merciful is God? Is it rachamim yesh lo? Another thing, Bezrat Hashem, let's see. Okay, and it's very important, Bezrat Hashem, it says, ve'a'er enenu betoratecha ve'davek livenu b'mitzvotecha, to mention all of the time, please, during Shavuot, please see that we are always engaged with Torah and our children. And the children that will come to this world, Bezrat Hashem, all the time mention this. And what's important in order, and I'll show you how we, by doing this, we eliminate the power in heaven and on earth, heaven and earth, of the Esav. Look, Bemidbar Sinai, but Bimbar Sinai, this equals Shalom. Vayomer Hashem el Moshe Bimbar Sinai. The desert of Sinai equals in numerical value Shalom, which is 376. Okay? Who is Shalom also is Esav. Esav is 376. Ayin is 70, Shin is 300, Vav is 6, 376. When we are united, like the children of Israel were united, when they received the Torah, received the Torah on the mountain Sinai, then what happens? How can we be united? Only if we are humble. If there's no humbleness, there's no unity. So look at the word Sinai. Samech is 60, Yud is 10, another Yud is 10, Nun is 50. How much is it together? Okay, this is 130. With the word Sinai, plus one, Ima Kolel, this is 131. 131 is the word Anava, humbleness. Ayin is 70, Nun is 50, Vav is 6, Hey is 5, it's 131. What also is 131? The Samech Mem, the evil inclination, which is the angel of Esav. The Samech is 60, Mem is 40, it's 100, it's 100. Plus Kel, Aleph is 1, Lamed is 30, it's 130, plus 31, it equals 131. The name of the evil inclination, which means our humbleness, okay, closes the evil inclination. Evil inclination is the angel that is fighting for Esav, is the angel of Esav. So by having peace, only if we are humble, we can have peace. If we think that we have pride and we are better than others, we can't have peace, we can't be united. But when we are united, that's why it's Bemidbar Sinai, in the desert, that we will understand, all of us, that Hashem created the rich people, the less rich people, the smart people, the less smart. Hashem created all of the creation. So only when we are humble, we can eliminate the power of the evil inclination, because then we'll have peace. The evil inclination, and then when we have peace, Esav doesn't have any power anymore. And Mashiach is here. So let Bezod Hashem, let's bless that we will all have this food to greet Mashiach. Tzidkan barachamim rimim rabbi aminu amin. You know what, I didn't give you this, but it says in the Midrash, Baruch HaRachman, blessed is the merciful, Shenatan, Torah Meshuleshet, that gave a triple Torah. What triple Torah? Tanakh, Torah Nevi'im Ketuvim. That Le'am Meshulash, a triple people, which is us. We are Kli, we are a vessel, Kli, Kohanim, Levim, V'Yisrael. And then, Al Yedei Shlishi, who is the third one? We have Miriam, Aaron, Moshe Rabbeinu is the third child. Bayom HaShlishi, on the third day, after the boundaries that Hashem told Moshe Rabbeinu, put a line around the mountain of Sinai, 3 days they are not allowed to come near to the wives, they should go to the mikveh and immerse themselves in the mikveh, and after the third day, they receive the Torah. And Bachodesh HaShlishi, what is the third month? We have Nisan, that is considered the first month by the Torah. Iyar is the second month, and Sivan, that we receive the Torah, is the third month. Ezrat Hashem. So let's bless that we will all have the zchut to greet Mashiach Tzidkan Rachamim Ha'Nivora Bimeinu Amen. Eliyahu Navi Zachul Atov, Lelam Yipared Adam Mechavarot Bar Halacha Yachid Berabim Halacha Kerabim. Achenu Kol Bet Yisrael, Hanetonim Batzara Ubashviya, Omdim Ben Bayam Uben Bayabasha, המקום ירחם עליהם, ויוצא מצרה לרווחה, המאפלה לאורה, ומשיבות לגאולה, השתה ואגלו, זמן קריב, ימרו, אמן!